Welcome back, friends. Now we are going to talk about the antisense RNA technology. We know about the gene silencing, and gene silencing can be done in three different ways. One way we can do the gene silencing. Normally, gene silencing means we don't want any expression of that gene. That means we don't want any copies of protein made from that gene, from the signaling of that gene. So the idea, it can be done that we can prevent the expression of a gene in three different ways. First is that we can completely remove that gene. We can do that by gene knockout process. Second approach that we can do is degrade the regulation of this expression of gene in the transcription level. And third type of regulation that we can do is that prevention of the expression in the translation level. Because you know the central dogma of biology, and it states if there is a DNA, the DNA will make mRNA. This is the first level where we can prevent. Second is it will make proteins. So this is the second level that we can prevent. Okay. So actually, according to my write-up, it's the second, this is the third level. And the first way is that completely remove that DNA. This is the first way to prevent it. So there are the three different ways a gene can be silenced. To take this gene completely out of the individual's body. This is the first thing. Second is do the prevention at the time of transcription of the DNA. Or third thing, do the prevention of the expression at the time of translation. That means prevent the mRNA. Okay. Now, gene silencing can be of different types that I told you, many different types. Now, in this video, we want to focus on the gene silencing by RNA technologies, or gene silencing by RNA. Because RNA is very important molecule to target a specific DNA or mRNA and degrade them down. That can be done very easily. RNA can degrade selectively. RNA can select and degrade DNA strands using RNAi or RNA interference mechanism, right? The process of RNA interference mechanism, I already explained in a separate video. So you can watch that video to know about details in the RNA interference on RNAi technique. But in this video, mainly we are going to talk about the antisense RNA technology, which is another way of preventing the expression of a gene. But this time, this antisense RNA technology is the prevention of the expression of the gene in the translation level. That means we use a specific sequence of RNA, which is known as antisense RNA, to block and degrade mRNAs. Okay, so our target will be mRNA, and with which we will degrade? By RNA, antisense RNA. That is our idea. So we know that this degradation of genes are required for prevention of certain diseases. So let's assume here, this is the gene, as I talked about earlier, that this is a SOD1 gene, which is mutated and cause ALS. So to prevent that, we want to degrade all the expression of this gene, because if this gene is expressed and the proteins are made, it can cause ALS. So let's say this DNA, this gene produces lot of mRNA in the cell. Okay, mRNAs are taken out. Lot of mRNAs in the cell. Okay. So what we need to do, we need to degrade those mRNAs so that they cannot be translated further. To do that, we use the antisense RNA technology. Now, what is antisense RNA? Antisense RNA is a complementary RNA strand of the mRNA. Right? So, a DNA produces mRNA by transcription, and what we can do is we can design a segment of RNA which is having sequence complementarity against that mRNA. Okay? So, let's draw it here. Let's say CGUAA. Let's say this is the mRNA that we are targeting. So we want to degrade this mRNA. So if we know the target mRNA sequence, we can easily design the antisense RNA. because it will be the complementary of that mRNA. So the antisense RNA that we design will be complementary, so it will look something like this. This is the antisense RNA. Okay, and normally antisense RNA are not very long, it's maximum to 20 nucleotide long. Okay, so there are 15 to 20 nucleotide long sequence of RNA which is having complementary against the mRNA of our target. Okay, so this is our target that we need to break down. It produces this antisense RNA, and the important thing about antisense RNA technology is that we can inject this antisense RNA from outside into the individual's body, and this antisense RNA can go there. It can bind with the mRNA sequences as they have complementarity in nature, and then it will take the help of RNase H. It's an enzyme in our body, RNase H. RNase H can selectively break down this mRNA sequence that is present there. It will break this mRNA down. So RNase H will be recruited. RNase H will be recruited. It will break this target mRNA down. Okay? So we can get rid of all the mRNAs. So if we get rid of all the mRNAs, there is no way the protein will be produced. Right? So this is a way to go against specific diseased DNA in our body. Okay? This is antisense RNA mediated gene silencing. There are also these RNAi mediated gene silencing. Now the difference between antisense RNA mediated gene silencing and RNAi mediated gene silencing is that RNAi mediated gene silencing works little complex manner. It will involve many different proteins. It will involve the production of a complex known as RNA induced silencing complex or RISC. It also requires a specific protein or enzyme to degrade, and that is dicer to generate. And the RNAi depends on the template RNA, which are much longer, twice as much longer compared with this sequence length of the antisense RNA. Okay, while antisense RNA technology is much basic, the number of nucleotide sequences up to 20 nucleotide maximum, and this antisense RNA can go easily bind with that. It can degrade this by RNase H, and RNase H, by the way, is an endonuclease, and you must know this because it can degrade the RNA strands from middle, and it's not specific, it's a non-specific endonuclease kind of enzyme. So this is the major difference between antisense RNA and RNAi. Antisense RNA you can easily inject it from outside, it can do its job like that. And the prevention by antisense RNA technology is to block the synthesis of protein from mRNA. So we are degrading mRNA here. So we are not targeting the DNA or gene, we are targeting the mRNA which is produced by that DNA. But the problem with this antisense RNA, as we are targeting mRNA, there will be many copies of the mRNA produced from the specific genes. So we need to have very high concentration of antisense RNA delivered inside the cell to go against the produced mRNA. Okay, so that in a sense is antisense RNA technology and antisense RNA technology mediated gene silencing. So if you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and definitely subscribe to my channel to get more videos like that. Thank you.